Sunday, with the in the and reason here I read this one is in the name of the one who came last in the body of our baptism, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Holy Spirit, I believe in you, Lord, and I thank you for the body, and for the life, and for the covering of the Holy Spirit.
And we pray our prayers.
Holy Spirit, we have been blessed with the passing from the truth and truth of the Father, and people to the ministry of justice and compassion. Come, righteous Spirit, and bring to our hearts. Holy Spirit, we fill the disciples with joy and prayer and power and love to preach your word and share your goodness. Come, Spirit of power, to make us to the witnesses of your redeeming love. Holy Spirit, we appear at Jesus' baptism.
Liberating Spirit, and free us from sin and death. Holy Spirit, Lord, and giver of life, and the fullest being of all things, you will be renewed to see your face in heaven forever. Come, Creator Spirit, and make us new creations in Jesus Christ. For God, I thank that we may remain standing for him. We hope that now that we should be with the Holy Spirit and the Lord is recording, we are understanding.
The face of the king from you, knowing you as being with
week, Mankato and the surrounding area received 11.75 inches of snow between Monday and Thursday. But I guess that doesn't have to tell you that you see the massive snow burden just as easily as I do. Again, for another time this winter season, many of us were confined to our homes for a few days. And I always have a time on home.
From going to was someone trying to tell you what was acceptable or not. There was someone trying to put Jesus in a box. But it wasn't the tall man that tried to step forward to do what Jesus was asking. In fact, the question that he wrote to him in the piece that wrestled with was Enoch, why would Jesus need to be baptized? If drawing baptism was part of the basis of sin, then our Holy Bible teaches that we confess that Jesus was done. The story of Jesus' baptism is written about in all four of the Gospels. But more times than not, I am trying to mouth it. Because only the Matthew account, we get this dialogue between John and Jesus. Only in Matthew's account, we can see John putting it aside. Only in Matthew's account, we can get the answer from Jesus himself as to why he's trying to call for baptism. This Sunday, as we move from the Christmas season to the rest of the Christmas, there are two things to remember. The first is that in the incarnation, the blessing of Jesus, God became man. But second, here at Jesus' baptism, the waters of the River Jordan are worse than shoulder to shoulder with degenerates and dwellers, with prostitutes and drug dealers, with adulterers and tax evaders. As Jesus gazes on this crowd, he sees these humans wading into the water, confessing their transgressions, leaving the skeletons from their closets, bodily there, like a family of children in the top of a stone. In these waters, the pure and spotless, the perfect and obedient Son of God, the sinless Messiah, becomes the biggest sin the world has ever known, because in this world, he first corrected the sins of mankind. passed by the Jesus Christ, your bride and Jesus Christ, nothing can be seen on the world but Christ. And while we were still sinners, our righteousness, Christ died. And we are baptized, no longer does God live in us by what we have done in the past, but as we go through the world, the success or failure, your destiny or tomorrow, before baptism, a day you likely don't even remember, a day you likely forget, in the arms of your mother. If your baptism is God's sins, it's the love of God, pure and righteous. You can touch it. You can feel it. Knowing that you take on the heaven of heaven, knowing that you are heaven towards your destiny, towards your fixed purpose,
Thank you.
Father, I want to thank you for your time and I am the shadow of your wounds. Those who suffer from illness, addiction, and loneliness, this is your son.